How's everybody doing tonight? I've been playing shows since I was 14 years old, and I have never, ever in my life gone more than a month without playing a show. I've been super lucky. I've been super privileged in that way. And going, what, like almost 2 years without playing a gig, I never really fully realized just how dependent upon this thing that for the last 10 years I've been saying is going to break my back. I should probably leave. But I fucking need this. I hope you need this too. We're so grateful. Fiddlehead is a band that stands against death and depression because we know the absolute savagery that it wreaks on the individual human being who sometimes loses control of that savagery on other people. This is a song that doesn't sound so hardcore, but it's one of the most hardcore things I've ever had to think about.
Thank you.
to a little secret society known as the Acoustic Donkey Riders. The only person who gets that is the person who that song is about. Peace and love and happy marriage to the Hudons, Ryan and Jackie Hudons.
Come on!
huge thanks to Akulu. Raising the stakes on musicianship and art and hardcore in every fashion, facet. And to the, well, they're not the Day One homies, but it's my favorite song by them. But to the Great Big Bad Blair for keeping the vibe right. I want to send this one out to three former students of mine. We'll be right back. Avery. I lied, that song wasn't up for you. This one is. This song is about my time over at a prestigious university over here in Providence. And in case you didn't know, prestige is like a misnomer. It doesn't mean elite, it means fake. And I just want to send it out to the students who I know actually care about learning, and I'm not just saying that because they were good students, but because they were good students who seemed to actually be interested in using history and critical thinking to better the world, starting and participating in the anti-racist club at the school, and actually meaning it. But in addition to the clubs and the awareness, it's just the genuine atmosphere that I think students like them, who I just absolutely love and appreciate, are a part of the project that Corey was talking about, of liberation in this world, in the truest sense, personally and collectively. So peace and love to everybody who knows that AP and Ivy doesn't mean a fucking thing. It's what you're doing in this world! I appreciate you. shutting the fuck up. But about 20 years ago when I first started going to shows, the riot girl scene, the moment in the 90s where it seemed like people cared, gave a shit, organized at shows, it was starting to fade away. And you heard a lot of less talk, more rock, motherfucker, stop preaching. Get off your fucking soapbox. Well, the last 20 fucking years haven't been all that fucking great. And so I appreciate people like Corey, bands like Move, and organizations from the ground that know the pain and the suffering of taking a human life that has done wrong and not trying to make it better. My brother has been in the prison system for 10 years for an unviolent offense. And I've never talked about that. But he's getting out in November and... I wish I could say it was a wonderful thing. Because it is. But so much of his self is fucking gone. Because he was thrown into a corner. And if you don't believe in organizations like Families for Justice is Healing, well, let me tell you, he got out for a couple months and he spent 3 weeks, just 3 weeks, in an actual rehabilitation center. And he had 3 beautiful months, but he fucked up again. And they threw him back. You gotta end this shit. It's fucking ancient bullshit. We're better than that. You don't like the slogan abolish prisons? Fine. Reimagine rehabilitation.
Thank you.
Life is a wild ride if you live it.